Hello again, everyone. Lucas Berry here for White Oak Rail. You know, we've all had those kind of days, right? We go out for rail fending and we get one, maybe two trains in a day. And we've even had some days that we don't get anything. But then there are those days where it just seems like everything is coming right at you. Either it's converging where you are or it's passing where you are on the way to where it's going. This is the story of one of those days for me. I'd actually gone out to catch Amtrak 50. I saw that there was a heritage unit leading, and I had got this engine many, many years ago. It was a really bad shot. It was me on a really bad cell phone camera with no tripod trying to hold it when I wasn't all that stable with the camera. So I figured, you know what? I want another shot at this thing. I have a tripod now. I've got a really good camera on my phone. Let's try this again. Out to Thurmond I went, and it was a good shot. But I also discovered a lot more than what I expected. So this is the story of that. This is Thurmond. We have the meats. As I drove into town, I noticed RJ Corbin had brought a train full of loads down, and I knew they were waiting for Amtrak to clear before heading out on the main line. I got out of my car and immediately found a nice surprise. CSX-A906. It's an EMD ST70AH. It's a Tier 4 emissions compliant SD70 ACE. Just with a unique CSX model number. CSX took delivery of 10 of these brand new in 2019. I have to confess, I did not expect to see it in West Virginia. I got my footage of 8906, and as I turned the corner to the old station platform, I found another surprise. An empty coal train sitting on the number 1 main, again waiting for Amtrak. It's shaping up to be a pretty good day. Not long after I set up, and here came the train we were all waiting for, PO50, the eastbound Cardinal, with Amtrak engine 145 up front. .145 pays homage to Amtrak's Phase 3 paint scheme, which came into being in 1976, and is arguably the most recognizable paint scheme Amtrak has ever had, adorning those famous F-40 PHs and many a locomotive over the years. In fact, it's still used on some equipment to this day. As 50 leaves town, they make some noise for the construction crew working on the new ADA-compliant platform here in Thurmond. Then you get a great look, but it seems like work is progressing kinda nicely, and it should be open soon. After Amtrak passed, I waited to see which of our two trains was going to move first, and the answer was neither. I had no idea there was another train coming until I barely made out an engine number from my scanner. Not easy when you've got two trains basically side by side and you're in the middle. Because I could barely hear the scanner, I have no idea what train this is or where it's going. All I know is it's an eastbound grain train. Thank you. After the grain train passed, I again waited to see which of our trains would move first, and again neither of them did. Same situation as last time. I could barely make out another train calling a signal approaching town. This time an eastbound coal train with another EMD riding second. Again, I have no idea what train it is or where it's going. Given that these are CSX hoppers, I'll say it's heading to Newport News. Now that we've got those two on up the road, it's time for one of our trains to move. First up is the empty coal train, so we don't know exactly where he's going. I should note here, the grade is not that steep here. This is what happens when you don't align your tripod, ladies and gentlemen. I had it lined up for that shot of them on the number one track sitting there, and I didn't think to change it when I saw them rolling.
Alright, now that we've cleared everything out, it's time to get these loads out on the main line. And we're pulling out onto the single main and then backing down the number one track and tying her down. We're standing almost directly across from where the old engine house was here in town, and would you believe it was used in a movie? The movie Mate One tells the story of the Mayan Wars in the 1920s. Thurmond stands in for the namesake town down in Mingo County. And how did they do that? Well, they used several houses around town, made the engine house look like a store, and even rebadged the depot to say Mate One. Nickel Plate Road 765 even has a few scenes in the film. I highly recommend it. I was just about set to pack up and head home when I heard that RJ Corman had a train waiting for them in Restaurant Siding, and they were about to leave for PAX. Having not seen them leave town empty, I figured I'd stay and film it. First, though, we'd run those engines around the train and get them pointing in the right direction. I'm standing near where the old freight station was here in Thurmond, and that got me thinking. The engine terminal is no more. The passenger station isn't even primarily used for passenger trains anymore. Yet 150 years after they first laid rail here in town, they are still hauling coal out of these mountains. Incredible. Thanks for watching. Please be sure to like the video. If you like the video, leave a comment down below if you are so inclined. If you have not done so, subscribe to the channel. It would be much appreciated. And while you're there, hit the bell to be notified when a new video gets posted.
Until next time, somewhere out there on the railroad, I'm Lucas Berry for White Oak Rail.